Hi everyone, this is in continuation to my last initial review of the Creality CR5 Pro. So I have been using this printer for now a month, and I'll try to cover the issues and the fixes and the print quality and the general overview of this printer now. So as last time I have told that I was getting a heating issue with the motor, so I have rectified that now, and let me show you now the close up. So first let me talk about the print quality now. So I would say the print quality is now acceptable to an extent, and I'm getting a decent result now. So this required a lot of tuning in the settings, and I have to go through all the things in this printer to check everything. So when you receive this printer, the issue is you have to check all the nuts and bolts, because you will find issues like few of the bolt or screws, even the belt tensioning. Everything has to be checked to make sure that it is working correctly. And this is what I even think the quality control issue with Creality is. If you go online and check their reviews, you will see a lot of people have good reviews, like their printers are working out of the box, and then there are people whose printers are totally like giving very bad results from the start only, and they have to like really work on this. So first thing was the cooling issue. So I have to install this fan. So I have now installed a fan and heatsink now, and this particular motor is working properly now. And initially it was around 71 degrees when it used to print. It used to reach that temperature. Now when I check now, it's around 45 degrees. And the second issue was with the cable. Now cable I have tied here with the screw here, so that no issue comes. And this motor wire also comes through here, and it goes in the power supply. So this is a 12 volt fan I'm using here, and for that I have to use a buck converter to convert 24 volts to 12 volt and use this fan. And so this fan is silent and it's on all the time. For the other motor which is here, so I have added a passive heat sink here. Now this motor, after checking it, touches around 60 degrees, so that is okay. So I have left it like that because I don't want to again install another fan there. So regarding the issue which I reported initially with the rusting of the rods here, so this issue is still there. And so I have bought this from 3idea in India, and so they will be the people who will be honoring the warranty, and they are trying to get it from Creality for more than 1 month now. And so again, the service of the Creality is like, even the importers of the printer, they are not able to get the parts from them. So even the service to them also is very poor. So I am thinking of replacing these rods with Mizumi rods, and I have located a supplier, and I will be upgrading them in the future. So other issue is the belt tensioning. There is no way to tension the belts here. So if you see these belts here, so there is no way to tension this, or it is very difficult. You cannot tension this because this belt is attached here with screws. You cannot get inside this. It's very difficult. On the top there are two screws through which you have to do everything. Two screw holes. If I can show you here, you can see here there are two screw holes, and they align with this gantry here. You have to come from top and then do everything, and it is very difficult. So, and even I have asked this question in their forum also, but I didn't get any reply how to do this, because my belts were not tensioned properly. So then I found this model on the Thingiverse, and which really helped me. So if you can see this is really good actually. So this I was able to tension the belts now. They are much better. So the x-axis has a tensioning mechanism here. There is a single screw here, and there are, you can loose it and push it back and then tighten it. But for the y-axis, there is nothing. So that is the one issue. And another issue that I recently found is with respect to this cooling fan, if you can see here. So this is a 24 volt fan, and I was printing ABS, very small parts, and I needed cooling. So then I found out that this fan, you cannot control the speed of this fan. You can either switch it on or switch it off. So this is not a PWM fan. So I had to fix that by adding a small capacitor. So I have added a 4.7 microfarad capacitor. With that, then it is I can control the speed now. But this is a very crucial thing that should have been given out of the box. Speed control on the fan, and that was not given. I don't know why they had not given this, or they have overlooked this important thing. Other issue is even the body is, if you see the body, like last time also I said, this is all metal here, this, and this is very sturdy, but the weak point here is this gantry, if you see, it is not very rock solid. And the reason behind this is the main holder where the bearings run is plastic here, and here also this is some sort of plastic here. So what happens is, even when you are doing a bed leveling in the center, I can see it never touches. So this has a manual bed leveling again. So when you level all the four points on the corners and then you reach center, you will always see there is a small gap, and that might be due to, because the bed is flat, I have checked, the bed is flat, it might be due to these rods, and it takes very little pressure to see this. I don't know if you can see this, but very little pressure, you can just bend it. See this, it is moving. So this is the weak part here, and due to this thing, you cannot achieve very high printing speed, or even I would say average printing speed. You have to print at a slow speed. So to fix this issue, I had to go through all the screws and tighten all the welds, because if you try to increase anything above 60 or 70 millimeter per second, then you will start seeing ringing in this. So this is the model that I printed with it after tuning. So I think it took around 8 hours to print, but I think it came out decently now. And the good part about this printer is I can print consistently with this printer. And now for the past 4 years, I never used to print with ABS. With this printer, at least I can print reliably with ABS material. And the bed temperature can go up to 100 degrees. So I print at around 95. By doing that, I do not get any issues with the bed adhesion when printing with ABS. PETG I have not tried yet. So maybe in future I will try that. So apart from that, one other issue I will like to talk about. If you see the size of this printer, and if you can compare the build plate, and if you look at the printer also, this is a copy of Ultimaker. That is what Creality has tried to do. They have tried to make this printer look like Ultimaker, but this is nowhere near Ultimaker, I will tell you. So the Ultimaker's new series, if you see, it is trying to clone that, or you may think this is similar to Ultimaker. But if you see, the build plate is very small, and in terms of the area, if you see the Ultimaker, Ultimaker tries to take till the edges, the build plate and the enclosure, there is hardly any gap here. But if you see here, there is so much gap, and I can just show you how much gap it is. This is a filament. You can keep two filament roll here without any issue, and one on the other side you can keep, and still you will have space left if you see here. So Creality would have given that the filament spools could be kept inside, but since they were trying to clone the altimeter, and this is the issue with altimeters also, the spool mount is on the back side, and accessing the back side is a pain. And what makes it worse in this printer is very heavy. So to access the back side, it is not easy. If you want to shift this printer, you see I am trying to shift this printer, and it is like very heavy, and accessing the back side is like a challenge each time. So I am thinking of doing a mod here where I will try to keep the filaments inside. So extruder and all I have to fix here. So apart from that, I will say this is my usage review with this printer for 1 month. So in conclusion, I would say this printer is not worth it. It is not worth the money that you will spend on this printer. And if you see, there are no reviews right now, and you cannot find any detail on this printer. And this is mainly due to the weight of this printer. The Creality is not able to ship it. If you see the availability in Europe and US, you will not find this printer many places. And the weight of this printer is the reason this printer is expensive, not due to the other parts like the motion control, this gantry system. This is not where they have spent the money. The money has gone into the body, and that is not adding any value to the print quality of this printer. And I would say the printer from the Creality, which costs half of this printer,